And it comes from the Tiboli tribe of Mindanao. Tiboli, as in Lake Cebu, it's a place up in the mountains with seven lakes. Very beautiful place, Lake Cebu. This is horsehair. Let me show you the anatomy of this instrument. It is in the shape of a lizard. Usually when you think of an instrument, it is the head, right, the neck, the body. But in this case, it's the tail, it's the body, and it's the head. It's a lizard. It's a lizard. It's got all these little carvings, the human drive to be ornamental. It's like having tattoos or, you know, Sanrio stickers in your notebooks. Same urge. Personalized, customized. This is a very modern instrument because the maker, who I never met, the maker carved a little airplane in front. And it's not your airplane with the wings spread, it's a profile of an airplane, which means the person saw a plane on the ground.
Yes.
Yes. Maybe the person was being taken by Manda Elizalde to, you know, fictitious tribes. These are electric guitar pickups. They come from a recycled bass guitar, so they are ecologically correct. Same with the tuning keys. The original were in wood, but they kept popping out in the middle of performance. Practicality reigns as far as evolution is concerned. And the switches, I love switches. Don't you love switches? You got switches on that thing? Nah. Come here. It's not real. It's not a real Filipino instrument. It's Spanish. Spanish.
So is your barong.
I didn't know this was Spanish. It is, because I think people were obliged to wear these because it's impossible to hide weapons under a barong Tagalog. So this is the precursor of the X-ray. You can see through it, see? No weapons. This song is entitled Ani Ana. Ani Ana means it's here. What is here? Well, when you cut down giant trees, a mountain starts to melt into the ocean. That's already happening. When you plant nothing but on a single crop to these huge tracts of land, eventually the land becomes an addict to fertilizer and will become barren and just have to keep on adding fertilizer. It's already happening now. Taking things that aren't ours and not replenishing them, we suffer the consequences. And environmentalism is not something about the future. It's not about future generations. It's about today. It's like love. You cannot say, "I love you tomorrow." You know, that doesn't work. It has to be an everyday thing. And it happens in our everyday decisions, where to put the trash. There's a house where I've been staying in for the past few days. It's called Pusod. Pusod. It's an ecologically correct house. Whatever that means. It's in the process of being built and it's got recycled parts and everything. So it's a very interesting place to visit. I think they're opening in February. By that time, it will be a really nice place. Pusod. Pusod means navel. Okay. A lot of people say Pusod.
No.
But Pusod is the bun, hair bun. Okay. Pusod is the navel. So it's a navel base. That's easy to... Okay, now I ask you to sing Ani Ana. Your melody is like this. First line.
Ani Ana.
Ani Ana.
Second line.
Ani Ana.
Ani Ana.
Third line.
Ani Ana.
Thank you.
Thank you. Pastor Rick from Amara. We are Amara from the Lord. He gave us a drive to start coming in Bali. Feel like dancing? Raising, and I hope you're ready. Are you ready? Are you ready for it? Sir, that's good, good. I'm glad you're feeling good. I'm feeling good. I got my nice see-through shirt. You can see my nipples, excuse me, but that's part of the show tonight. So come on, people are still coming in late. Please, come on, Paso, Tuloy, go ahead, it's okay, great. Welcome, this is going to be an extraordinary evening because we've got it full of some wonderful, wonderful music. And music by Filipinos. That's right. Filipinos. Where are the Filipinos? Are there Filipinos here? This establishment. I believe so. Because tonight we've got a poet, a world-class musician, just a legend. Joey Ayala is here tonight. You're very good. In a program called Kwentong Mindanao, Mindanao Stories. I think it's going to be just a wonderful. If you haven't had a chance to see Joey's been here for about a month and a half now, and he's performed all over the Bay Area. And if this is your first time getting to check him out, finally, this is great. I'm glad you're going to be in for a wonderful treat. Also, tonight's program, we're going to be seeing some video also from Howie Severino. Yeah, okay. Yes, Howie fans. And Howie fans. Howie! Also, if you're kind of wondering, the screen is here. This is for the Tagalog impaired right here. We're actually going to be translating some of the wonderful lyrics. The lyrics are very important. And if you don't know Tagalog or you have problems with Tagalog, look at the screen because the lyrics are readable. But for the Tagalog impaired, we have this area right over here. Don't be ashamed, though. It's okay. It's all right. I know some of you only know the dirty words. That's okay, though. That's okay. So we're gonna have the words on the screen over there. So don't worry. I'm glad you're here. This is a wonderful fundraiser for a wonderful, a beautiful place that is being restored right now over here on Fifth Street in Berkeley here, called the Busud House. Have anybody been to the Busud House yet? Now, if you haven't had a chance to go over there, it's just a beautiful house over there, and there's a performance space as well. So make sure you check that out. And of course, this is to raise consciousness as well as funds to help build Busud, which is much needed here in the East Bay. Am I right, East Bay people? Am I right? So make sure you support all Busud events. We have a table that's going on right over there that has announcements and flyers of many of the Busud events up and coming. Also on that table is the famous Jeepney Dash Records. Yes, that's right, I know you heard of it. Jeepney Dash Records, which was established just last year. Now this is, they have four releases already. Two spoken word and literary releases. One of the band that you're about to see right here on stage, and the brand new CD by Joey Ayala himself called Hubat. So make sure you grab one if you haven't had an opportunity. It's a limited collector's edition. So if you're a big Joey fan, make sure you grab one. Brought to you by Jeepney Dash Records. And also just say hello to Bernie over there and E over there, Eric. They're going to be they're at your service. Provide you with some wonderful, wonderful tunes out there. Okay, are you feeling ready? Are you still feeling warm? You feel the you just feel it inside of you? Do you? Okay, gotta scare them sometimes. Well, this band that's about to grace our stage, they make their home at Mendelstift Studio, the other epicenter of Filipino-American performing arts in San Francisco. This band is also a kind of given birth by a group called Tongue in a Mood. And we're just very excited to bring bring them here, right here on the La Peña stage. So please, put your hands together. Come on. Put your hands together. Yeah. Okay. All right. There you go. Feel it. Feel it. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, all the way from San Francisco, it's the legendary Bobby Bandoria and his band.
Thank you.
Jinjin's pretty good.
Good job, I got the job.
Yeah. You got a future, Jinjin. That song goes out to a good friend, Olivia, who's off to the Philippines in about 3 hours. And this goes out to all the brown-skinned ladies who...
Well, all right. Here's an oldie but goodie. Here's a tune called Pandango Mi Ba. Jun, you all right? No, you don't know it. He just came here today and I was gonna. He said, I play guitar too. I can say no.
Thank you. Get to be a drag. These
as his lungs get cold when the winter comes, chills you right to the bone, and you wish you were home. Oh, little brown man in the land of the giants, little brown woman on the white prairie. Hold on to your dollars, don't go on no shopping spree. You gotta save it all for the family.
Somebody told me it does not exist. It's Filipino spoken with an American twang. I don't know, so I'll leave it to you to judge. And these original Pilams will help me add credence to my performance.
Endangered species.
cable TV. Remote control koi binitiwana ang channel mo'y di papalitan sa aking mundo, ikaw ang biodiversity. Chemical
ow!
pusang nakapaan. Naliligong katawan. Kambing nagmemeryenda. At marami pang iba. Ayun na. Mga batang walang pantalon, nagtitimbol ng mga dalaga kasama yung mga pangalan.
Alam niyo, kahit matanda na ako eh, nahilig pa rin akong manood ng mga chicks. Problema lang, laging naninigas itong aking tuhod. Here's a song from another song from Mindanao. It's in the 80s when Marcos was the president. It was a very paranoid place to be, Mindanao. I was working in an office, and one day I heard gunshots outside of the office. So instead of, you know, people in Mindanao, they do not run for safety. They run for curiosity. Two dead bodies, two guys just come out of the restaurant. Apparently they were overweight policemen, as most policemen were at that time. No longer. They're trimmer now. Yeah, more room for hiding stuff. So here's a song from those paranoid days. You have the words? Yeah. Thank you. ikaw na may baril. Mabigat ang iyong pasanin. Pagkisil mo ng gatilyo, ilang buhay ang kikitilin. Ilang anak kang iiyak, o di kaya'y di may sisilang. This next song is entitled Bangkerohan. Bang, you know bangka?
Yes.
Bangka is a boat. In Davao, there's a river, Davao River. And in the old days, when there was no bridge, you had to take a bangka to get across. So that place became known as Bangkerohan, where the bangka and the bankeros are the bankeros, not the bankers, but the ones who rode the boat. And in those days, I was a journalist. I made money writing for a newspaper called the San Pedro Express. But it was primarily features writing I was doing. I go to a meeting of the Bakers Association and make it sound interesting. That's what I do. That's my work. Yeah. I'd go to the Car Dealers Association. Hope they pay me with a car, but it never turned out that way. And then one day, our editor said, we're going hard news. Features just doesn't pay too much. So I had to learn how to become a news reporter. And one day there was a fire, Pangkeruhan Public Market, a huge fire that raised the whole public market, and a grenade explosion. There was a grenade explosion for one reason or another. And my assignment was to find the circumstances of the death of several people. So I had to go to a hospital and interview the survivors. And I discovered it's very hard to interview someone who is in pain. And then I went to the funeral parlor, I tried to interview the parents of one of the women who had died. And it's practically impossible to interview someone who's crying. And so I gave up the journalistic career, and I decided to write a song instead. So here's that song. Almost a movie star. Sorry, hindi po masyadong kapisado yung gitara.
Isang gabi nagkasunog sa pareke, ako ay nakisali sa mga naking isisa. Biglang may pumotok at nagkabulong ulo. Dagan, dagan, dagan. Mga tao'y nagsigawan. Mabuti na lang at ako'y nagapang at naligtas sa pinsala. At natmahirap ang umilag sa shrapnel ng granada. Kapag ikay tamahan, labas ang iyong bituka at kung kay swerte yung daging sa ospital. Masahan kung ikaw ay dead o naray, banat ganyan nga ang nangyari sa aking katabi. Ang batak ay tulungan ng mga nasunugan at napakagalala ang kanyang gantipala. Isang libre tiket sa kalangitan. Diyos ko, Diyos ko, Diyos ko, ito ba ang inyong kagustuhan? Ilan na lang ang mga magigino, sila pa sa kadugay-dugayan. Unti-unti mauubos ang tatawan nyo. Pastilan, pastilan, pastilan. Sasabihin ng buong bayan, ang syudad ng Davao ay wala na tao. Ang Davao ay sementeryo. Dito, 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 isa lang ang aking buhay. Parang bago gustong gawin,
popular in the Philippines. And the only model for the use of the answering machine was, of course, the American model. So people would spend time mastering the machine, mastering the diction, the proper diction, appropriate to the technology. Hello, I'm not in right now, so please come in. Hello. Hello, and then the phone rings and you pick it up and go, hello, I'm not in right now. It's story and true story.
Functions
and they have to, you know, ng date, architecture. You say, lucky po. Tapos nandun to exacerbate the conditions of their, you know, lack of etiquette. The old cultures, the belief is that nature is a repository or a residence of consciousness. And the proof of that is us. Assuming that we all come from a single source and that we assume that we are conscious, kindly check your neighbor. Is the person comatose or conscious? Okay. So consciousness exists everywhere. And that leads us to the question, what's the difference between a human being and a chair? I think the human being is more apparently conscious. I would assume that chair does have a certain amount of consciousness, but not enough to instill unnecessary delights upon those who are seated on the chair. Here's a song, and maybe the chair will come to life while you're singing it. I will request your assistance in this song. The chorus. Tabi po, tabi po, patabi ro. And you say,
Apaglarong encanto.
Which means playful enchanted ones, playful nature spirits. So,
tabi po, patabi ro.
Yeah, you have to give it a little hip hop feel, you know. Pull your pants down a bit. I practice.
Tabi po, tabi po, palabi mo.
And when you hear a frog, you have to answer in kind. You can use the English equivalent of frog or cribbit. Well, depends on that. And when you hear the puliglig is a small insect that lives in the forest. Sounds like that.
Puliglig.
It's a very academic insect.
My
very academic. Okay, you can also answer in time. No. Insectology.
Sobrang dulas ay kapilid ang magyapak. Inubad ko ang bagong sakatos ko. Tinali sa aking backpack. Gumapagpaakyat sa putik at bato. At nakarating sa balikat ng bundok. Naglakat patungkong sa makapal na kahuyan. Nakarating sa daang matamo. Ng sapatos ko'y isusuot na sana. Kanang na lamang ang nabitira. Saan naman nakarating ang katiwan. Kung nalipibalik ay hindi pa rin makita. Ano ngayon ang gagawin ko? Isa na lamang ang sapatos ko. Ito na ba yung sinasabi nilang pinaglaruan? Tabi po, palabi mo. Tabi po, palabi mo. Tabi po, palabi mo. Sa pangkakapalak ay nagkukukukakan ng mga damit sa may patakbakan. Paano matutulong niya?
Tabi po, tabi po, palabi mo. Tabi po, tabi po, palabi mo. Tabi po, tabi po, palabi mo. Tabi po, tabi po, palabi mo.
Ha ha ha.
sa lupa't himbing na himbing natang na ko nakita sa kalit at sa humagay sa pari sa sapatos kabukal ng akin humangon na ko tiningnan ang sapatos nakaduda-duda na sa akin na ito paano na ko o di ko pong alam ito na siguro yung pinaglaruan inom ako sa ilog ngunit lalo na uhaw naupo sa patong malaki ay yung malaki kalabaw kinalakad na ang pababa ngunit lalo akong nawala.
Squatter areas in the neighborhood. I was among the landed families. Ayala, my name is Ayala. Laughing. But it's a Chinese Ayala. So one of my ancestors, the first one who became an Ayala, supposedly, this is according to my father, was a pirate. And he would, supposedly, not 100% sure, but knowing myself, probably. He would kidnap people from the islands, soften them up in his dungeons in Intramuros, old city. Yeah, complete production design with manacles and everything. And he would sell them to the rich people in Manila. Among these were, of course, the Spanish. Ayalas, Isabel, Ayalas. When business people, such as my ancestor, who makes business out of people, so these are business people. We were required to take on a Spanish surname. He took on the surname of his best client, to Ayala. So that's why I have to write songs that are nutritious and good for the people, because that is my karmic debt. Here's a song to all of you who are landless. So fear not. We aren't born with titles in our hands. So we can just be cool. Be cool, huh? That's a Phil Ang joke. I heard that here. Napatid, may napatid, tapos sabi niya, sabi niya, neither was the playmate. wala ba kayong mapaglagyan sa lupang kinagisnan? Sa hampas ng halo, sa halos ng dampawan, patuloy kayong gumagaman, yapos-yapos ng butikan. Subalit sa lahat, layan niyo'y nadaratnan, lumulutang sumisisi sa telalim lali.
I'm not promoting tourism.
But if you ever do go to Manila, be kind. Yeah. Be cool. One of my best memories about growing up in Quezon City was walking around with a kariton. Yung mga barkada ko, my friends were all magkakariton. So we go around doing ecologically correct things, picking up bottles in a newspaper. This was in the 60s, a long time ago.
It's been 2 hours and I'm still sitting here. Holy children outside my window asking for money. Do they take my heart instead? A bit too young to know despair. It's not polite to stare. I tap 3 times on my window. The light turns green. I step on my clutch. I shift into my shame. But I don't get far. I wish this highway rise on up into the sky. I wish this four-wheeled thing would grow wings and learn to fly.
Children all around, only family lost and
such another Mindanao song. I did not realize it, but this song is very Chinese. The title of the song is Edo, which means river. My life is a river reaching towards the sea. A river. First world. Anyone, if you, can you read? It's okay.
Ngunit dapat pa rin ang inaan.
sa kagawasan. Soon.